Hello and welcome to our course on Access 2016. My name is Toby and I'm your instructor on this course. I'm a Microsoft Certified Professional and my specializations include Microsoft databases, and Access is a product that I've been using for a long time. It's also a product that has changed significantly in the last couple of versions, and it's now much more flexible and much more powerful than it's ever been. So I'm really looking forward to showing you how to use Access, and in particular I'm looking forward to helping you to find out how Access can help you to manage some, at least, of the large amount of data that we all deal with nowadays in both our work lives and our home lives. So first of all, who is this course for? When I designed the course, I really had three groups of people in mind. First of all, people who've never used Access before, maybe never used a database before, or at least not knowingly, and very certainly who'd never designed a database or built a database before. If you like, they're the primary group of users that the course is intended for, and I'm really going to start Access from scratch. However, I will assume that you have a reasonable knowledge of the use of Windows software. If you've used components of the Microsoft Office suite, such as Word and PowerPoint and Excel, then you should have plenty of knowledge of the use of Windows software to follow this course. But I do assume that you can find your way around a Windows application, so you'll understand things like icons and clicking and double-clicking and right-clicking and so on. The second group of users are people who've used a very much older version of Access, maybe Access 2000 or 2003. For those people, the current version is so different that it'll probably be a bit of a shock. You may not even have used Access with the ribbon interface that's been with us now for nearly 10 years. So you probably need a pretty big refresh in your knowledge of Access to be able to take full advantage of this latest version. The third group of people are users of more recent versions of Access, and if you're in this third group, you may well have used the ribbon before, but you may not be familiar with the latest features, including features such as the creation and use of web apps, for example. Now, for that third group, and to some extent for the second group, I will try to point out from time to time sections of the course where maybe if you've used Access before, you don't need to follow that section because it probably only contains material that you're familiar with anyway. But in general terms, I think it will benefit all of you to go through the whole course in sequence, step by step, because there may well be things that you need a refresher on, or maybe when you tried to use them before, you weren't exactly clear on what was going on. And I am going to try to explain things systematically in what I believe is a logical learning sequence. Now, during the early sections of this course, I'm going to have to cover some basic material, some introductory material. Some of it you may be able to skip, some of it you certainly won't. But here are a few points, important points, just to get us started. The version of Access that I'm going to be using is the full-blown desktop version of Access 2016. I'll tell you a little bit more about versions later on, but it's the desktop version that I'm using. I also need to make it clear that I'm not going to be covering what's called VBA programming on this course. If you've got no idea what VBA programming is, then don't worry about it. We will be looking at macros a little, but we won't be covering programming, so this is not a programming course. And also, I'm recording this course on a touch device, but I won't really be using touch very much at all during the course. In fact, in a few sections from now, I'm going to explain touch in relation to Access, in fact, in relation to Office in general, just to give you a few hopefully useful pointers. But virtually all of this course is done using mouse and keyboard. If you are using a touch device, you should be able to follow the course through perfectly well, but I'm not going to explain everything twice because it would make the course extremely long. It'll be long enough as it is. But basically, I use mouse and keyboard on this course. And another very important point is that you will need to have a live internet connection for many features on the course. Now, to be fair, there's an awful lot you can do without being connected to the internet, but for some things, such as online help and for downloading database templates and certain other things, you will definitely need a live internet connection. And when we start looking at web apps, you'll need a connection as well. And one final introductory point, I'm recording this on a widescreen device. It's 16:9 display. So the way that my screen looks and the amount that I can get on this screen, and it's quite a big screen, may well be different to yours. Essentially, whatever we're doing, the content should be about the same, but it may look different depending on the size and shape of your screen. But bear in mind that I'm using a widescreen desktop PC to record this, and I'm recording it on Windows 10.
Hi, Molly here. Thanks for watching. If you need additional Access 2016 training, get our free 3-hour course for beginners. Click the Get My Free Course button on the right. I'll see you next week with additional videos.